So this was recently published on my blog, and it's called Will Buys a New Game. It's super effective. A pair of 20-something bros dressed and posed in a manner that was such a hilarious cliche, if I described them exactly as I saw them, my editor would have said, "You have to rewrite that, it's too cliche." Stood near the front of the store, communicating in some kind of Groglish language that leaned heavy on the word fuck and its many derivatives. I'm rated M. I should have said that when I walked out. Sorry. I guess I'm old man weak. Let me just pause for a second and tell you an old man weak story. There's these kids who live up the street from me, and they're sweet kids. They're really sweet kids. They're like probably, there's three of them, they're like probably 7, 8, and 10. And they like to ride their dirt bikes, like you do. And they race their dirt bikes up and down my street all day long. And my street's on a little bit of a hill, and my driveway is a hill. And like you do when you're that age, they like to race their bikes as fast as they can down the hill and then sort of let their momentum carry them up my driveway. You know, sort of like pause at that sort of like apex of like, I guess, you know, dirt bike weightlessness, and then speed back down the driveway. And I saw these kids doing this like maybe 2 weeks ago, and they were, the thing is, none of these kids are wearing bicycle helmets. Now, look, I never wore a bicycle helmet until recently, and, you know, I didn't get that much head damage to myself. But I was worried, you know, because people tend to drive too fast on my street. And these kids were racing down out of my driveway, and I just kept replaying this image over and over in my head of the kids racing down the driveway and just getting hit by a car. And the secular humanist in me was like, I should probably go out there and tell them not to do that. And then like the practical realist in me was like, you're gonna get sued for the rest of your life if they die riding their bikes on the driveway. So I opened up, my son and I, Ryan and I, were sitting in the house, and I saw this happening through the dining room window, and I said, I gotta go, I'll be right back, I gotta tell those kids to be, you know, to not do this. So I walked out and I said, hey, you guys, really love what you're doing. And it's like, you like really, like with the skidding and like the skidding to the side, like you guys are, you know, like you're doing whatever the bicycle equivalent of cleaning the cube is. Like you're really, you guys are boss. And because I wanted to speak to them in a language that they would kind of understand. That's what I think of. So I was like, look, dudes, the thing is, I'm worried that someone's gonna hit you when you race down the driveway like that. So, like, I don't want you to, like, not ride your bikes or everything, but, you know, just don't ride them down my driveway like that, all right? And the kid looks up to me, like he's sort of like the alpha child, looks up to me and goes, school, bro. Which is good, S apostrophe cool, bro. Okay, I understand that. And I said, thanks, sorry. And the kids, you know, go right up the street, and they continue their riding up and down the street, but they're just not, they're not coming up the driveway anymore. And I go back inside, and my son says to me, well, congratulations, you just told kids to get off your lawn. I tore a bunch of tendons in my ankle when I was working on Eureka last year, and I had to walk around with a cane for almost a month. And it was kind of cool. Because everywhere I went, people were like, oh, would you like to sit here? Can I hold this door for you? And I got into this habit of like using the cane to like push buttons in elevators and stuff. Stuff around. The cane very quickly became an extension of my arm, but nothing in the world was as satisfying as shaking it at people. Anyway, so that's the, probably the longest old man meeting footnote. I mean, that easily took up 7 or 8 pages. As I was saying, before that happened, I guess I'm old man weeping because I looked around at all the 7 and 8 year olds in the store. If you've forgotten where we were, there were bros. And I felt mildly offended that these two bros couldn't be bothered to make an effort to, you know, just like tone it down a little bit. But such is the way of the bro. If they had common sense and a wisdom staff, six plus two. Probably wouldn't be bros. And by the way, do they teach that, like, bro slouch driving posture, like, at the douchebag driving school? Because I'm behind graduates of that school almost every day. So I walked around the bros, and I went to the Nintendo DS games. And I felt like I imagine a teenager would feel when he went to buy his first box of condoms. So I felt my face get warm, and I caught myself like sort of looking around to make sure that nobody was really watching me, there was no one I knew in the store, as I reached for the nearest copy of Pokemon Black. So I looked at it, right? I turned it over and I read on the back and I thought, I cannot believe I'm really gonna do this. This is gonna happen. I'm 38 years old and I'm playing my first Pokemon. The bros left the store, trailing expletives behind them. I don't speak Broglish, but apparently something was a lot of fucking bullshit. The precious children I was so concerned about moments earlier didn't seem to notice. They probably play a lot of Call of Duty on Xbox. Or maybe I'm just a dad, nearing 40. I nervously drummed my fingers on the game as I replayed the conversation I had with Jerry about 2 months ago, where he assured me that Pokemon on the DS is a fun RPG that starts anew with each release and is incredibly fun when you play it with your friends. The last game Jerry recommended to me was Might and Magic Clash of Heroes. It is one of the greatest games I have ever played on the DS not called Mario Kart. So I trusted him. I trusted him enough to find myself standing in GameStop, feeling like I was renting porn, and wanting to ensure that I was getting big wet asses for instead of wet big asses for. Like you do. So I approached the counter, game in hand. Can I help you with anything? The guy asked me. Yes, I said, but you have to promise that you're not going to make fun of me. The other guy smirked, and the first guy told me that he would not make fun of me. Okay. I exhaled and realized that I had tensed up my shoulders. I forced them to relax. So, do you have Pokemon Light version? He sort of chuckled. The other guy failed to cover a laugh. Hey, I said, look, I can see that you're judging me. No, man, I just thought it was funny. We both play Pokemon, the other guy said. Yeah, it's nothing to be embarrassed about. It's a really fun RPG, the first guy said. That's what my friends told me. So, here I am, 38, buying Pokemon for the first time. I am given to understand that white version and black version are essentially the same. Is that correct? The other guy said that I had been correctly informed and added that it pretty much depended on what box I liked better. Oh, okay, so this one looks like a dragon? A dragonmore? Dragonlon? Dragony? Whatever, it looks like a dragon, and I think dragons are cool, so the first guy typed a few things into his computer. We have the white version, but we only have it used. You know, I actually prefer to buy games new to support the developers, I said. I felt a little self-conscious, like I had just extolled the virtues of fidelity while standing in a whorehouse. Or giving a shit about the middle class while standing on the floor of Congress. Seriously, fuck those guys. No worries, he said. Okay, so I'll take this, and I automatically just said, and Super Scribble Bots. Like, I want this lube, these porn magazines, peanut butter. No, not peanut butter. Socks. No, no, not socks. Something that doesn't go with this stuff, which is the real reason I came in here in the first place. Like an apple pie. Can I leave now? The Kroger is also cursed. He rang me up. Hey, he said, I really like your work on Big Bang Theory. I know this sounds weird, but I often forget that when I'm interacting with strangers, there's this non-zero chance that they know my name and have seen some of my work. It used to make me feel like I had an arm growing out of my head when it happened, But I've gotten over that, and now it actually makes me happy because I'm really proud of what I do and grateful to do it. I guess I should make a note that that's apparently an applause line. Do you want a bag for these? He asked. Which, come on, seriously, when you walk out of the pawn shop, it's those black plastic bags that all smell weird and you can never get the smell out of your car. And like everybody knows, but everybody pretends that they don't. Oh yes, I was just at H&M buying clothes, and they put it in that black bag that, you know, says shopping on it. No, it's totally cool. It's, what do you think I have here? Wet big asses for? No, I'm good, I said. I'll carry them out in the open so the whole world can know my shame. Thank you for your help. I walked out of the store past another employee who was explaining the differences between a couple of first-person shooter games to a guy who was about my age and seemed as uncertain about his purchase decision as I was about mine, but not nearly as self-conscious. The end. I chose, I think, is it Snivy? Is that how you say Snivy?
Yeah!
Okay, just, you know, by like going, Snivy.
Yes.
Snivy.
Yes.
Really? Because nobody knows how you say it, right? You're a child. How do you say it? The first way I said it. What was the first way I said it? Snivy? Okay, good. Yay, Pikachu! That's what I started with, because Leech Seed is boss, because Leech Seed is like, it stays in the guy even when you swap out Pokemons. But my god, I've been playing that game for like 56 hours and there's no end in sight. These are things Jerry and Kurtz did not warn me about. I flew to Germany last year and I was like, oh, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna sleep on the plane. No, I'm gonna play Pokemon the entire time. And then I'm gonna think about buying a power adapter from the onboard store. So I can plug it in and keep playing. Are you really jet lagged? Did you sleep badly on the plane? No, I was playing Pokemon. Aren't you a little old for Pokemon? Hey, it's a really cool RPG. Speaking of RPG.